mother. Hello, father. Here I am at Camp Granada. Camp is very entertaining. And they say we'll have some fun if it stops raining. I went hiking with Joe Spivey. He developed poison ivy. You remember Leonard Skinner. He got ptomaine poisoning last night after dinner. All the counselors hate the waiters. And the lake has alligators. And the head coach wants no sissies. So he reads to us from something called Ulysses. Now I don't want, this should scare you, but my bunkmate has malaria. You remember Jeffrey Hardy. They're about to organize a searching party. Take me home, oh mother fada, take me
home. Hi, Mom. I'm leaving for your camp now, Mom. Gonna have lots of fun. Goodbye.
You have a good time. Let's have a good time. What makes you feel real fine? Maybe the last time we get together here on earth. So for heaven's sake, let's have a good time. Sing tenor, boys sing bass. Maybe the last time we get together here on earth. So for heaven's sake, let's have a good time. Can I play?
Greater far than all my sin and shame. Oh, To our 25th anniversary program. We appreciate each of you coming and sharing with us. It looks to me like we got the same crowd here we had on Sunday morning. How about that? Anyway, we thought we shared today. We're just going to try to do a little reviewing today and try to have a little travel down memory lane. And for many of us, we'll try to touch on some things that you might have forgotten, and you maybe can help us with some of the things that we've forgotten. Now, the committee that planned this anticipated that if we put Harold and Mr. McConkie here together, and they get to reminiscing and so forth, we could be here all afternoon, and you wouldn't get a chance to say anything.
But you wouldn't have a crowd.
No. Okay, we wouldn't have a crowd. Anyway, I'm going to ask Mr. Holt back there to keep time, and when it gets to be 10 minutes after Harold starts, you ring the bell back there. All right, you're the timer, and you ring the bell. Now, he may not quit, but at least we all know his time is up.
Okay. The reason they put me first is because I'm the youngest. And I don't come across with a lot of that smart stuff that the guy that follows me will, but I'm going to take the roots, a little bit about the roots of the Little Rockies Christian Service Camp. This camp did not begin here on this location. Immediately following World War II, there were three explosions within the restoration movement. That is, people committed to the restoration of the church revealed in the Bible, its doctrines, its ordinances, and its fruits. One was the independent Christian, the independent missionary movement. That was one of the explosions. Another explosion was the what we call the Loyal Bible College movement, and trained thousands and thousands and tens of thousands of young preachers and missionaries to go into all the world and preach the gospel, including Montana. Now, the thing that fed a lot of the Bible colleges with students was the third explosion, and that was the Christian Service Camp movement. It was more or less centered in the Bible Belt, and there were people who came out to Montana to preach, and I'm thinking particularly of one very well-esteemed preacher by the name of Noah Hall, who came to preach at the 6th Avenue Christian Church, and some of you people are converts of the preaching of Noah Hall. About the time all this was going on, there was a little lady who had, out of Missouri, out of the Christian Church of Missouri, who had married a rancher, the son of the man for whom Phillips County was named, to have a CCC camp established here. Now, in 1949, Noah Hall held a revival meeting for me in a church in Holly, Oregon, and challenged Mary Lou and I to come back to Montana, where our real love was, and work with the 6th Avenue Christian Church in new church evangelism. And we came out, we preached in the little log chapel in Landusky, and that was my first glimpse of these buildings that we see here. And she was so determined that she was going to utilize these buildings for young people. When I first saw these buildings, I saw nothing but just a shambles of run-down, dilapidated things that were about to be hauled off across the mountain, you know, over the haze. And poor Mrs. Phillips, in desperation, was trying to find somebody who would be willing to stick their neck out and to organize and to put their work and their money and maintain some kind of a facility so kids have a place to camp.
I knew Noah Hall in Cherokee, Iowa, when he was there. And his daughter skated me on purpose into a post in the middle of the roller rink. I know. That's why I didn't marry her, and Butch's brother married her instead of me. But we were about that tall at that time. But we mentioned a man by the name of Herman Coy. Herman Coy baptized me at Storm Lake, Iowa. And these letters that I'm going to speak about cover about 19 years of history regarding this camp. The first letter is to the Honorable Roy Ayers, and it's dated December 10th, 34. And she, Mrs. Phillips, in 1934, asked that there be a CCC camp here. She said the reason for a CCC camp is to get a good road over the mountains to Hayes. The letters reveal to me that she always was looking way ahead on behalf of other people, not knowing for sure what was going to happen or who these people were. I didn't know this until I began reading these. How many of you know that these grounds were first set aside under the auspice of an organization called the First American Teepee Club? The First Presbyterian Church in Great Falls almost fell heir to this, and for a period of time had control of it. Named by me as following: General MacArthur's United Camp. That after she got it, that's what she named these campgrounds: General MacArthur's United Camp.
I want to take just a minute to finish up a little bit where Ron was at. Really appreciate, Ron, how fast you went through all of this good stuff. I asked a question down here in relationship to when do we get involved basically with the camp? But it was back in October of 1953 when the Little Rockies Christian Camping Association was...
The organizational meeting of the Little Rockies Christian Camping Association was held November 7, 53. And it says in here that those who were at the present of the meeting were Reverend Harry Buchelstein, act as temporary chairman, present at the meeting, Mr. and Mrs. Ben Phillips, Mr. and Mrs. Felix McCollum, Mr. Felix McCollum, Mr. Jess Van Vos, Reverend Harry Buchelstein, E.L. Gordon.
Anyway, as I understand it, it was used by some of the community churches in Malta. I mean, different organizations used the church around these grounds during that intermediate time. However, we were not directly involved with that. They went ahead and set up their own camp programs and used them in that way. I've met several people who live in this area who were converted here at this campground in other camp meetings from other churches before we started here. And so they've got a real love for this campground even before we got started with it, because their roots, Christian roots, come from here working with that. I wanted to take just a moment to kind of review some things about our camping programs. First camp was held here in 1969 in the middle of the summer. Now, I remember a little phrase that sticks in my mind many times when we think about camping or many other things, but the phrase says that you can count the apples on a tree, but you can't count the number of trees in an apple. And I think about Christian camping in that way, because we can count the number of campers, but there's no way that we can really count the influence and the impact they've had for Christianity as they have gone through this camp and out into the world and into their churches and other places they've gone to serve. And that is the thing that has motivated all of us to do what we've done in camping, again, is with that by faith we believe that the individuals who come through this camping program will continue to bear fruit for Christ all the rest of their life.
Amen.
And that is the root, the bottom purpose of why we do what we do here and have done what we've done all through our years. We believe in young people, we believe in God and using those people as they go through their lives. We have had a total number of 2,524 campers come through this program. Now, some of you are duplicates of that. You went to 3 years, so you're involved in it. So I don't know how many, you know, separate individuals we've had, but that averages out to about 126 young people here that we, as our camping association, have had direct contact with every year.
We have one father.
In a circle of friends.
life is through, but we'll keep you close as always. It won't even seem you've gone, 'cause our hearts in big and small ways will keep the love that keeps us strong. It's hard to let you go. In the Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long to live as friends. And with the faith and love God's given, springing from the hope we know, we will pray the joy you'll live in is the strength that now you show. But we'll keep you close as always. It won't even seem you've gone, 'cause our hearts in big and small ways will keep the love that keeps us strong. Yeah, yeah. And friends are friends forever if the Lord's the Lord of them.
Oh, hey, Cap Row of the Week.
Yep.
Great class, man. Great class.
Though it's hard to let you go, in the Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long to live.